Hello students, in this video I will be discussing about the line integral. If I have a curve C now, let me take the point A as P naught, the point B as Pn. This will be P1, P2 and so on. Now if you remember integral y dx, this was limit n tends to infinity summation I equal to 1 to n or 0 to n yi delta xi. Now on similar lines, if we consider f dot dr by dt, this will be magnitude of f along dr by dt multiplied with magnitude of dr by dt, because dr by dt is not a unit vector. So if we consider if we convert dr by dt to a unit vector, then this dot product will give us magnitude of f along dr by dt. Now something similar, if we consider we have f at pi into dr by dt at pi into delta ti, where delta ti is the value between delta ti is t at pi minus t at pi minus 1. So this integral would give us what we call as the line integral. So this is equal to integral C f dot dr by dt into dt, which is equal to integral C f dot dr. Geometrically, if F is the force, then integral C F dot dr is the work done in by F in moving a particle along C. And if F is the velocity, integral C F dot dr is called circulation of F along C. If circulation is zero, then we call F to be conservative. Or in other words, irrotational. Now the condition for the integral to be zero, suppose if we have a closed curve, if C equal to simple closed curve, that is curve only end point of the curve intersecting, that is no other part of the curve should form loops, then line integral along C is denoted as integral f dot dr. Now integral C f dot dr depends on C. Is independent of C if curl F equal to 0. Let us consider this example where we have to evaluate integral F dot dr. Now, dr is dx I cap, dy j cap, dz k cap. That is because r is xi plus yj plus zk. Now, integral C f dot dr is equal to integral C 2y plus 3 dx plus xz dy plus yz minus x dz. So to evaluate this integral, we need to substitute for x, y and z in terms of t. So this will be integral 2t plus 3 into 4t dx is 4t dt plus x is 2t squared, z is t cubed dy is dt plus y is t, z is t cube minus x is 2t squared so dz will be 3t squared dt. Now at A we have 0 0 0. This implies t equal to 0. At the end point B, 2, 1, 1 implies t equal to 1. So integral C f dot dr is integral 0 to 1. We can simplify this. 8t squared plus 12t plus 2t power 5 plus 3t power 6 minus 6t power 4 dt. So this will be 8t cubed by 3 plus 12t squared by 2 plus 2t power 6 by 6 plus 3t power 7 by 7 minus 6t power 5 by 5 for t equal to 0 to 1, which will be 8 by 3 plus 6 plus 1 by 3 plus 3 by 7 minus 6 by 5. And this simplifies to 288. So we'll make a note of this answer here. So along x equal to t squared, y equal to t, z equal to t cube, integral c f dot dr is 288 by 35. Now let us consider the same vector, but the curve is line joining 0 0 0 to 2 1 1. So this will not change. The only definition is the equation of the line. We need the equation of the line. So equation of line joining x1, y1, x2, y2. Now this can be written as x minus x1 by x2 minus x1, y minus y1 by y2 minus y1. So for third dimension, it will have a similar pattern. So when we apply the two-point formula for the third three-dimensional case, we get the equation to be of similar nature. So in this case, x1, y1, z1 is 0, 0, 0 and x2, y2, z2 is 2, 1, 1. So this gives us x by 2 equal to y by 1 equal to z by 1. So we can convert everything to a single variable. So we have x equal to 2y. If we take the first pair, we get x equal to 2y. So it is better to write everything in terms of y. So we get integral c f dot dr is equal to integral 2y plus 3 into 2dy plus x into z is y dy plus y into y minus 2y and dz will be dy. So we have everything in terms of y. So if you observe the point, now y varies from 0 to 1. So this will be integral 0 to 1. So this is integral 0 to 1, 4y plus 6 plus x is supposed to be 2y. So we get 2y squared plus y squared minus 2y dy, which is integral 0 to 1 integral 0 to 1, we get 3y squared plus 2y plus 6 dy. So this simplifies to y cube plus y squared plus 6y from 0 to 1, which is 1 plus 1 plus 6, which is equal to 8. So we see that when the curve is changed, the value of the integral also changes. Let us consider another example. So here again, dr will be dx I plus dy j plus dz k. So integral c f dot dr is integral c 3x squared dx plus 2xz minus y dy plus z dz. Now x squared is 4y and 3x squared is 8z. Now this we can write an expression for y and z in terms of x. So we have y equal to 1 by 4x squared and z equal to 3 by 8x squared. That means we can write the integral in terms of x. So integral c f dot dr will be integral 3x squared dx plus 2x into z is 3 by 8x squared minus y is 1 by 4x squared into dy will be 2x by 4 dx plus z is 3 by 8 x square and dz will be 3 into 2x by 8 dx. Since we have everything in terms of x, if you observe, the point is from 0, 0, 0 to 2, 1, 3. So x varies from 0 to 2. So simplifying this, we get 3x squared plus 3 by 4 3 by 4 from here and 1 by 2 3 by 8 x power 4 minus x cube by 8 plus 9x cube by 32 into dx. So this simplifies to integral 0 to 2 3x squared plus 3 by 8 x power 4 plus 5 x cube divided by 32 dx. So integrating this, we get x cube plus 3 by 8 into x power 5 by 5 plus 5 by 32 into x power 4 by 4 from x equal to 0 to 2. This will give us 8 plus 3 by 40 into 2 power 5 plus 5 by 32 into 4 into 2 power 4, and this simplifies to 3 into 4 by 5 plus 5 by 8, and this simplifies to